feels perfect. Other days it just ain't working. The good, the bad, the right, the wrong, and everything in between. Yo, it's crazy, amazing. We can turn our heart through the words we say. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Hope can live or die. So speak life.
Welcome to the House of Prayer Live Radio Ministry. You've got Sister Angie here, Evangelist Willie Grizzle, the better half. If you would like to call in your prayers, call 270-681-8098. Or you, if you'd like, you can call him on his cell, 270-943-8429. Stay tuned and God bless and keep praying.
It's like I'm drowning in the deep. Well, it's crazy to imagine words from my lips as the arms of compassion. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Hope can live or die. So speak life. You say, raise your thoughts a little higher. Use your words to inspire. Joy will fall like rain when you speak life with the things you say. Lift your head a little higher. Spread the love like fire. Hope will fall like rain when you speak life with the words you say. So speak life.
Well, glory, everybody. This is yours truly, the Evangelist Willie Grizzle from Scottsville, Kentucky, the House of Prayer Radio Ministry. I hope you tuned in to be enlightened, a little life spoke into you, and a little death to kill that sin. Amen. My friends, my family, today I just got back from this church down there in Glasgow, praise God, and it's called Faith United. Amen. Well, Lord woke me up this morning, praise God, and he says, go that direction. I went that direction. Amen. And I kept on going and going and going. And finally, the Lord says, right there. I want you to go right there. All right. So I went into that little church. All right. It's a nice little church and everything. What a normal church looks like. Amen. Praise God. But I told the pastor and the deacon, I guess you say, that I was an evangelist. And I had something to say to the church today. You know what they told me? They told me that, oh, you got to get an appointment. Or you can come another time, but tonight, today, God wanted me to talk to my people. He didn't say God's people. He said he talked to my people. Well, let me tell you something. If I have to come in there and scream and shout and you have to call the cops, well, I'm going to do my job. Praise God. So let's pray for that Faith United. Amen. And they need God in that house. Amen. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, today I just want to tell you, I'm going to give you a warning. Why does men of God sit and cooped up in a building? Praise God. You know, there's so many men of God out there, they're doing this and that and the other, but they want to stay caught up in the building. Let me tell you something. If you're not doing the will of the Father, you're doing the will of the devil. And all you just want to be patted on the back. You just wanted to, everybody to like you. Let me tell you something. I'm starting to think I'm the most hated person. Amen. You know, even friends of the past. Amen. That once I dedicated my life to the Lord, and every time I see them do something, I call them out on it. They don't call my phone no more. Amen. You know, praise God. You know, I got a brother of mine that called me last night. Amen. And he said, I haven't heard nothing from you. I said, well, the number ain't changed. Still the same. And he says, well, what number did you give me? The one you called. Amen. And anyways, he said, why didn't you call me? And I gave him, I said, well, I ain't had that number in almost 6 months. So, okay. And why's that? See, well, what we got to do, we got to go back to the old path, my friends. We don't need just to go here and there and preach a little bit and then go somewhere else. See, even Paul, amen, Paul come back. And he corrected the church when they got out of line. See, my friends, that's what we're going to be going to in Luke 11 today. Amen. Praise God. I got it on here, an audio Bible. I want you, we're going to listen to that in a little bit. Praise God. And then we're going to see what the Lord have to say. Amen. Praise God. So brothers and sisters, let's enjoy this testimony from Brother Boyd.
Hello, Brother Willie. I love you and I'm praying for you. God bless you. This is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. Thanks for keeping all of us in prayers here. We've been going through some tough times. My dad, Roy, passed away on us. We've got disabled people to take care of. We've been having a horrible time getting visas. They keep getting denied to bring my fiancée, Edna, and her daughter, Isabel, over here from the Philippines. And we need them over here to help take care of the disabled people with us here. And I may be having to go over to the Philippines soon. I'll let you know what happens, but keep us in prayer. I'm just too busy right now, and I'm no longer on Facebook for the time being, but I'll be trying to call into this testimony line when I can, as well as the other program line as I can throughout the days here, and I'll let you know what's happening. I'll be out of touch if I go to the Philippines for a while. It's hard for me to travel because of my allergy problems and food allergy problems, and I'm allergic to other things too, so thanks for keeping me in prayers for God to totally heal me so I can make that trip to the Philippines if I need to here. And I wanted to say a prayer for us all. My testimony is that I was controlled by pornography, lust, anger, cursing, and so many sins. I confessed Jesus as Lord. I was baptized in the lake. Jesus helped get those sins out of my life, and instead of sinning, I've been involved with different ministry stuff, helping small churches grow from the small missions teams to large mission teams. I spoke at different churches in the past and at different events. We've done all kinds of revivals and different events. I've been involved helping many different people in the prisons that have severe drug addiction problems. Throughout the years, I've been involved with helping many orphan and fatherless kids and discipling them and getting churches and people involved helping orphan kids and taking care of them. James 1:27 says the religion God likes is to take care of the orphans and the widows and to keep ourselves from being polluted from the world. And the Lord help me get the pornography, the anger, the cursing, the sin out of my life. If you just have me helping the orphans, the people in prison, and helping people in need instead of sinning. And the Lord put some fire in my heart and life to live for the Lord instead of sinning and got me truly born again. And the Lord can do the same thing for us, you also. If you'll truly turn your heart and life over to the Lord, He'll get that sin out of your life and He'll get you out there preaching Jesus Himself to a lost, dying, and hurting world and helping people get saved. Father, right now I want to come to you and pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. I want to pray for Brother Evangelist Willie Grizzle, for his wife, for his daughter, for his family there. For you, please touch him and heal him and help him, help his ministry. Please touch me here and help me. Help us to somehow get visas and find the president or senator or someone who can help us get Edna over here. Please heal me so I can go to the Philippines if I need to. Psalm 103 says you forgive all our iniquities, heal all of our diseases, redeem our life from destruction. Please, Father, forgive all of our sins and help us not to sin. Please heal all of our diseases, all of our sicknesses, and all of our ailments. We claim our healing right now. And please redeem our life from destructions and deliver us from our trials and challenges. Philippians 4:6 says we don't have to worry and you will help us. And we thank you for helping us in every situation of our life. As I pray this prayer, and I pray this prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus. God bless all. God is good. Jesus loves you.
Well, ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. Well, gonna hold my body down. Where?
That's right, my friends. There is no grave going to hold this body down. When I leave this earth, I'll be with the Lord forevermore. Praise God. But you know, we got a battle today. Praise God. You know, there's so many churches on each corner of the world today that they want to preach to the ones that they feel friendly to. Amen. They want to be patted on the back, my friends. This church here is not to be patting on the back. It's to warn you, my friend, that the death is coming to your door. If you're not right with God and you call yourself to be a man of God, but you're just doing what you want to do, you go places where you feel welcome. Let me tell you something. You're going to feel a place called hell. And let me tell you something right now. You ain't going to be welcome there. It's going to be torture and suffer all your days, eternity. My friend, see, you need to get out and about. Go places where you've never been. Obey God. Because there's so many people today has forgot to obey God. Because they, oh, well, I can't help this minister. He's too loud. And my neighbor's talking about him. I can't do that. Oh, no, we can't do none of that. Well, let me tell you something. If you don't obey God, this is what's going to happen. You're going to be registered as a disobedient child. And that's a fact, my friends. See, Jesus, when he walked this earth, my friends, he was telling everybody he knew the power of God. Amen. He was telling them how to live. He was telling them how to pray. He was telling them the power of God by showing them. See, we got the power to show people in this world. But too many people have caught up in theirself. Amen. Pray for me. I've been choked up all day. The devil's been trying to shut me up, and it ain't going to happen, my friend, because today is a day of salvation. Praise God. You know, so many times, men of God will sit here and we'll study and we'll study and we'll study. Amen. And it's like putting water in a jug with a top on it. And we'll fill it full of water and just sit on it. See, that's what the church house is doing today. They're sitting on the Word of God and only going where they feel comfortable. What about the ones out on the side of the street that's starving today? Come on, you hear me? What about the ones that's sitting in the alley high on drugs and alcohol? What about them? But you want to sit in your church and be comfortable. You don't want a man of God to come talk to your people because they might change their mind way you're teaching or preaching. See, that's the problem with the world today. They want somebody they can hold on to. Somebody they can see. They don't want to feel that unseen hand, that precious Lord and Jesus Christ upon their life because they are caught up in their self. See, the Pharisees had that problem one time. You know what I mean? They called Jesus the devil. He was casting demons out. Now think about this, my friends. We both to be on the highways and byways every second of our life and telling that devil where he belongs, and that's in the pits of hell and under our feet. See, a sermon the old boy brought today was in Ezekiel 31. Amen. He was talking about dry bones. Amen. But he come off with something that kind of throwed me for a whip, and he knowed it. Amen. He started talking about that the devil had power. Only thing he's got power is mouth. He runs his mouth. That's all the power he's got. And then he said that the devil couldn't talk to the body of Christ. Quunk, wrong. See, he's got a platform too. He can run. Just check out all these preachers on YouTube. Check out on Facebook. Check it out all of them. And then watch where they go and how they do it. See, you're being deceived, my friends. You need to open your eyes. The devil is doing his job. He's getting people to run away from church. He's getting their children to blame it as homosexual. He's blaming, they're allowing my little girl about 3 years ago. See, my little girl's fixing to go into the ninth grade, okay? She's in eighth right now. About 3 years ago, she was in sixth grade. And they sent a paper home. And they said, one of the teachers, sex education. I wrote that paper, I'll teach my daughter about sex education when it's appropriate time. Let me tell you something. The world is being deceived. They're allowing sin. They're putting laws of sin now. That's all right. You can go marry a man. Marry a man. A man marry a man. A woman marry a woman. It's all right. They got a freedom of choice. Yeah, they got a freedom of choice to go right straight to hell. That's what they got the choice to do. See, my friends, you got to stand up, proclaim the word of God, because the world is being deceived by this fake Jesus. All Jesus loves sinners. Yeah, he does, but he don't love their sin. See, a lot of people, they forget that out. All he loves a sinner. Yeah, but he hates the sin. See, my friend, we're going to be judged by a God that is more powerful than anything that this world has. He could speak words and you'd be gone. Now, understand that? Praise God. You know, we got to understand that he don't have to slap you down. He'd speak to you and you're done. Do you understand what I'm saying, my friend? This is a powerful God we serve. That when Jesus come to this earth, he didn't come to make friends. He come to heal the sick, the demon possessed. He didn't come for the righteous. He came for the ones that was lost and undone. The ones that are sick. The ones that had palsy. The one had cancers. The one had diseases. He came for the ones that truly wanted to be healed. He didn't come for the righteous. Righteous set up on their own pedestal. They read what scripture said, but they didn't apply it to their hearts, my friend. This is why I go out. You know, I had a criticizer, you know, I get one at least twice a week, telling me, Willow, well, we got so much drugs going on in this neighborhood, why don't you preach here? I have preached here. But what about you? What about your children? What about your husband, your wife? What about you? See, I'm only one man. I can't be in 10,000 places. God can, but I can't. That's why I get behind this mic and preach my heart out that some one soul, just one soul, turn away from their wickedness. See, I'm a warner. I'm a prophet of God. And if you're a true man, woman, God, you're a prophet of God. See, we both be out preaching the gospel, my friend, not playing pity-patty and having youth gatherings and having picnics everywhere you turn around and just having revival once a year and program it in. See, when a revival breaks out, my friend, you know what revival means? That means that you're getting renewed, getting filled up with the Holy Ghost to be sent out and conquer the world and tell that devil his days are numbered. See, the word says it. See, we already won, my friend. Just accept it and move on. See, my friends, it's time that we unite together. You know, I've tried to unite with other believers in Jesus Christ. Okay, let's say that. But everybody wants to be a chief. Nobody wants to be an Indian. That's the problem. They don't want to see each other as equals. They want somebody to have some kind of seniority. Whatever happened about worship and praising in spirit and truth? What happened to that? Do you think Jesus come the ones and had the robes and gowns and all the pretty things of the world? No, he came for the ones with a broken heart. The ones that had needed God. You remember that little lady that had that blood disease? Do you think she was caring about what she was wearing when she crawled through that crowd and touched the hem of that garment? Do you think she really cared what people thought? No. Because she knowed if she touched that hem of that garment, she'd be healed. She ready to give everything she owned to cure for this disease. But she knowed without a doubt that God was in the presence in the flesh. And she crawled through that crowd just to touch his garment. Will you crawl through a crowd of all these wicked doers just to touch God's garment today? Will you stand up and proclaim the word of God? Or will you just sit in a little cooped up building and sing Kumbaya and sing a little song, pass around an offering plate, and then go on home? See, Today is a day of salvation, my friend. It's time to wake up. Because tomorrow could be too late. Your number could be up today. So, brothers and sisters, I give you my heart.
This is my desire.
praise God. You know, that's one thing we got to do, is we got to give all our heart to God. But it just seems like everybody wants to give their heart to a building or give their heart to their family. But see, the only way that you're going to truly walk with God is you must fully surrender, my friend. You can't just say, well, I'll go to church on Sunday and I'm just fine. But let me tell you something. There's a hell to shun and a heaven to receive. My friends, too many of this pity-patty going on in the church house. See, we're the church. We both to be out with a loud trumpet, our big mouths, and out there preaching the gospel. But no, we want to sit up when we're comfortable. We want to let the preacher talk and we listen and we do nothing. Let me tell you something, that doing nothing will get you into hell quicker than anything. See, it's a shame how this world has turned to hatred. And the biggest part of it's in the house of God. Well, I might get dirty. I might have to. I can't do that because somebody might resent me or they pick sides. I don't care what you pick. I'm picking Jesus. I'm going home with my Lord one day. And I want to be going home with no blood upon my hands. That's why I'm warning. Because Jesus is coming. You know, I got an email. Usually, things don't bother me. Amen. But this email kind of hit home. Amen. And this is what this email says. Brother Grizzle, why do you continue to play Brother Boyd's testimonies? It sounds like he's saying the same thing over and over and over again. Don't anybody else care to call? Well, first thing, I can't put a gun to somebody's head. Second thing, these testimonies Brother Boyd calls in has changed people's lives. I put them on CDs. I've given them to truck stops. I've given them to nursing homes. Did they give me a dime for it? No. I don't want nothing. Because I've got what's coming to me in the rewards in our Lord Jesus Christ. But I'm going to continue on with this email. He's talking about a pastor of a church that said he used to be friends with. To my knowledge, I think we're still friends. But he's claiming that we're not. And he says, why does not this pastor come to your ministry? Why does he look down on you? Well, see, the biggest problem is people today wants to look at somebody with suit and tie. That wants to look perfect. I got tattoos. I got a loud mouth. I serve the Lord with this little building here when I'm home. A 16 by 20 building. It's not little, but it's full with the Holy Ghost. And another reason is I don't take money. I don't care for nothing for it. I know some evangelists is going to get mad and upset. I don't care. You go ahead and make a sermon. You've been doing it for the last 2 years anyways, so go ahead. I'm telling you something. If you have more thoughts about money and you preach more about money and about all these other finer things, you're going to get what you deserve at the end. You're already getting your reward. But on this matter of this email. See, a lot of people will try to get under my skin. But I don't live that life anymore. I don't care about people's opinions, attitudes, or mouth. Because all they're doing is wasting air and wasting time. See, we all got a time limit till we leave this earth. See, my friends, I'm not going to get caught up in a cult. To sit up in a, cooped up in a little building and tell you a bunch of sugar gospel. I'm going to tell you the truth. The church is lacking because they get caught up in material things and not doing spiritual things. See, that's why the youth don't want to come to church, because they want to play their little video games. They want to watch their little nonsense videos. They want to be something to tickle their ears. They don't want the truth, because the truth hurts. I tell you, when I do wrong, and I know it, I can feel it like a knife blade. Especially when you get some of these highfalutin preachers that want to call you out or use your example. Let me tell you something. You can cut all you want, but I know the Lord's going to cut deeper than you could ever cut. See, my friends, the House of Prayer Radio Ministry is to bring the truth and the Word of God. You know, like it says over here in Galatians 1:9, as we said before, so I say now again, if any man preaches any other gospel unto you than that you have received, let him be accused. See, my friends, there's the real gospel and there's the fake gospel. See, there's false prophets out there, my friend, going and devouring churches up every day. My friends, today we need to understand, if you call in here, amen, I will play the testimonies. I don't give a care if it's the same thing over and over and over again. Somebody needs to hear it. At least he calls instead of getting a bunch of silly emails. I'm telling you, God's coming back. And when he does, you better be on his right hand when he comes. Because there's all this hogwash that's going on in the churches and fairy tales and skits and all that nonsense. Let me tell you something. All that's going to burn one day. See, I'm trying to pull you out of hell, and you keep sinking yourself into it. My friends, if you have a church, let God control it. If a man or woman God comes in and he's got something to say, let him say it. You're not a judge of them. God's the one put them that direction. You might as well let them speak. You never know. It might be something that you need to hear. Amen. So let's listen to another testimony from Brother Boyd.
Hello, Brother Willie. I love you and I'm praying for you. God bless you. This is Brother Boyd Blandon in Idaho calling in with my testimony. And I'd like to encourage people to call in with their testimonies. Call 270-681-8098 and share your testimony. It says in the book of Revelation, they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and testimonies are powerful. I can tell you, we've been going through a lot here in Idaho. My dad, Roy London, had a horrible stroke, battled with infections for 3 months and passed away later last fall and winter, early winter, and which is too bad. And my mom, Jerry London, is 76 now. She's been having some heart problems. She's been under a lot of stress, and she's weaker now. I'm taking care of her, taking care of my mom's mom, my grandma, Yomi. She's going to be 96 soon. And my sister, Ann, here has schizophrenia, weighs 550 pounds. She's on level 4 and level 5 oxygen. She's got to have pillows given to her all the time and food, and she just, stuck in her bed on breathing machines all day long. And I tell you, it's a lot of work taking care of everyone here. And I had prayed about it. We've had just horrible problems of trying visas, trying to get my fiance Edna over here. They make it extremely hard for people to come over here from third world countries. We tried twice now, and the visas have been denied. And We've got a lot of stuff. I'm going to be trying to talk to senators and the president to see how we can try to get visas for Edna. I've had allergy problems. It's real hard for me to travel, food allergy problems and other allergies, but I'm praying for me to be healed. I may be going over to the Philippines very soon if that works out, so keep me in prayers. And the Lord told me that it's just too hard for me right now to work Facebook stuff over there, so I ended up shutting both my Facebook accounts off. I didn't block anybody, but I've just got so much to do here that I had to shut down my Facebook accounts, and I just don't have time to do the prayers and this stuff on there. I just got too much to do here, and we're trying to get my fiance over here. I may be going to the Philippines, and we're trying to talk to a bunch of people and write letters, just plus taking care of everybody. I have a lot to do, so thanks for keeping all of us in prayers here. And what I'll be doing is I'll be calling into this program line with calls and preachings and messages that I think can help people that can go on the CDs, and I'll be calling into Brother Bishop Eddie Cheney's line also. Brother Bishop Eddie Cheney has a great program line, testimony line also. It's the Gospel Music Jukebox programs, and Brother Willie does the House of Prayer programs, and they're great programs. They help us out, and I'll be calling into the testimony lines as much as I can and making calls in, and if I can and have enough time, I'll get in the programs live. If not, I'll listen to the programs in the archive and put some comments in there too. So anyhow, thanks for keeping us all in prayers, and please be praying it'll work out so I can get over to the Philippines soon here or do whatever I got to do so I can get my fiance Edna over here. We need God's help with everything that we're doing, and I know that we're going to overcome and that God is helping us and Jesus is good. Jesus will help us and God is good. That's my testimony. So have a good day and God bless all. Amen.
Praise God. Thank you, Brother Boyd. Continue to call in. No matter what kind of racket everybody's giving you, you're a man of God, and you obey God. If you just want to repeat the same message over and over and over again, you can do it. Somebody's going to be touched, and a blessing's coming. My friend, we got your prayer on this end. And I got this little notebook here beside of me, and I take it, and wherever I go, wherever I preach, we pray over it. And we preach over the prayers. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, enjoy this song. Love alone is worth the fight.
For my own oasis, so close I can taste this, the fear that love alone erases. So I'm back to the basics, I figure it's time I face this, time to take my own advice. Love alone is worth the fight. Love alone is worth the fight. And I never thought I'd come to this, but it seems like I'm finally feeling numb to this. The funny thing about a name is you forget what the reason you were playing the game is. And it's all an illusion, a 21st century institution. So I'm headed down the open road unknown. And we'll find what we made of. For the rhyme and reason, are you born, why you leaving? What you fearing, what you believing? Why you living and breathing? Why you fighting it and getting it even? Let's go headed down the open road unknown. And we'll find what we made of. Through the open door.
Amen. Amen. What would you fight for? To keep your children, your husband, your wife from going to hell? You know, it's a good question. Every day I talk to my wife and my little girl about God. And sometimes they roll their eyes and sometimes they listen. See, we just can't just sit cooped up in a building and think God's going to bless us. See, if you want something from God, you got to ask him. You got to do something instead of sitting on your tail and listen to a few little words. See, you got to get out. You got to be obedient to God. See, it breaks my heart to see all these churches. We got, I know at least 104 churches around here, and they got more sinners around them than they do in the house of God. What's wrong with that picture? I tell you what it is. They want to feel comfortable. They want to be liked. Let me tell you something. You ain't going to be liked in hell. There's going to be a bunch of screaming and hollering and misery. I'm telling you to save your soul today. I'm telling you that you need to wake up. It's time to knock him old scabs off like old Paul. Remember in 3 days, he walked in darkness, scabs upon his eyes. But when he did see the light, oh, he knew who the power of God is then, didn't he? My friends, don't be put in the darkness. Let God in your life. And this is, and this, what I'm fixing to play here is from Luke 11, the whole chapter. I want you to listen very closely, because this is what's going on in the world today. My friends, listen closely.
Luke 11. And it came to pass that as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray, as John also taught his disciples. And he said unto them, When ye pray, say, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as in heaven so in earth. Give us day by day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And he said unto them, Which of you shall have a friend, and shall go unto him at midnight, and say unto him, Friend, lend me 3 loaves, for a friend of mine in his journey is come to me, and I have nothing to set before him. And he from within shall answer and say, Trouble me not, the door is now shut, and my children are with me in bed, I cannot rise and give thee. I say unto you, though he will not rise and give him, because he is his friend, yet because of his importunity he will rise and give him as many as he needeth. And I say unto you, Ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh it shall be opened. If a son shall ask bread of any of you that is a father, will he give him a stone? Or if he ask a fish, will he for a fish give him a serpent? Or if he shall ask an egg, will he offer him a scorpion? If ye then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask him? And he was casting out a devil, and it was dumb. And it came to pass, when the devil was gone out, the dumb spake, and the people wondered. But some of them said, He casteth out devils through Beelzebub, the chief of the devils. And others, tempting him, sought of him a sign from heaven. But he, knowing their thoughts, said unto them, Every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation, and a house divided against a house falleth. If Satan also be divided against himself, how shall his kingdom stand? Because ye say that I cast out devils through Beelzebub. And if I by Beelzebub cast out devils, by whom do your sons cast them out? Therefore shall they be your judges. But if I with the finger of God cast out devils, no doubt the kingdom of God is come upon you. When a strong man armed keepeth his palace, his goods are in peace. But when a stronger than he shall come upon him and overcome him, he taketh from him all his armor wherein he trusted, and divideth his spoils. He that is not with me is against me, and he that gathereth not with me scattereth. When the unclean spirit is gone out of a man, he walketh through dry places seeking rest, and finding none, he saith, I'll return unto my house whence I came out. And when he cometh, he findeth it swept and garnished. Then goeth he and taketh to him seven other spirits, more wicked than himself. And they enter in and dwell there. And the last state of that man is worse than the first. And it came to pass, as he spake these things, a certain woman of the company lifted up her voice and said unto him, Blessed is the womb that bare thee, and the paps which thou hast sucked. But he said, Yea, rather, blessed are they that hear the word of God, and keep it. And when the people were gathered thick together, he began to say, This is an evil generation, they seek a sign, and there shall no sign be given it, but the sign of Jonas the prophet. For as Jonas was a sign unto the Ninevites, so shall also the Son of Man be to this generation. The queen of the south shall rise up in the judgment with the men of this generation and condemn them. For she came from the utmost parts of the earth to hear the wisdom of Solomon. And behold, a greater than Solomon is here. The men of Nineveh shall rise up in the judgment with this generation and shall condemn it. For they repented at the preaching of Jonas, and behold, a greater than Jonas is here. No man, when he hath lighted a candle, putteth it in a secret place, neither under a bushel, but on a candlestick, that they which come in may see the light. The light of the body is the eye. Therefore, when thine eye is single, thy whole body also is full of light. But when thine eye is evil, thy body also is full of darkness. Take heed, therefore, that the light which is in thee be not darkness. If thy whole body therefore be full of light, having no part dark, the whole shall be full of light, as when the bright shining of a candle doth give thee light. And as he spake, a certain Pharisee besought him to dine with him, and he went in and sat down to meat. And when the Pharisee saw it, he marveled that he had not first washed before dinner. And the Lord said unto him, Now do ye Pharisees make clean the outside of the cup and the platter, but your inward part is full of ravening and wickedness. Ye fools, did not he that made that which is without make that which is within also? But rather give alms of such things as ye have, and behold, all things are clean unto you. But woe unto you Pharisees, for ye tithe mint and rue and all manner of herbs, and pass over judgment and the love of God. These ought ye to have done, and not to leave the other undone. Woe unto you, Pharisees, for ye love the uppermost seats in the synagogues and greetings in the markets. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye are as graves which appear not, and the men that walk over them are not aware of them. Then answered one of the lawyers, and said unto him, Master, thus saying thou reproachest us also. And he said, Woe unto you also, ye lawyers, for ye laid men with burdens grievous to be borne, and ye yourselves touch not the burdens with one of your fingers. Woe unto you, for ye build the sepulchres of the prophets, and your fathers killed them. Truly, ye bear witness that ye allow the deeds of your fathers, for they indeed killed them, and ye build their sepulchres. Therefore also said the wisdom of God, I will send them prophets and apostles, and some of them they shall slay and persecute, that the blood of all the prophets which was shed from the foundation of the world may be required of this generation, from the blood of Abel unto the blood of Zacharias, which perished between the altar and the temple. Verily, I say unto you, it shall be required of this generation. Woe unto you, lawyers, for ye have taken away the key of knowledge. Ye entered not in yourselves, and them that were entering in ye hindered. And as he said these things unto them, the scribes and the Pharisees began to urge him vehemently, and to provoke him to speak of many things, laying wait for him, and seeking to catch something out of his mouth, that they might accuse him.
Amen. Praise God. That's going on today. You got some say that they're body of Christ, and they just sit there in your church waiting for you to make a mistake. To say something that they can use to build, to make services about, to mock you. I mean, this is going on now, my friends. Beware. Woe unto you, Pharisees. You think about what you want and how things should be done in your traditions. You're not doing the traditions of God. You're doing the traditions of your father. And your father, if you're not right with God, is Satan. And that's the truth, my friends. Why does men of God sit cooped up in a building? Because they want to get their happy on. They don't want to be what they're both to be, men of God, fighting the devil on the side of the road. Fighting the devil in schools. Fighting the devil in the government. That's what we both to do. We both to fight the faith that our Lord gives us. Where we can go home. My friends, my family, I've brought you the word. And I've told you what the Lord had me tell you today. It's time to quit playing pity-patty and get real with God. Because there's going to be a day that you'll answer for every deed you've ever done. And I hope today that you come to an altar somewheres in your heart, beside your chair, out in the road, anywheres, and you seek out God and see if I have not told you the truth. We're living in a dangerous generation. And our Lord is drawing closer every day. So my friends, my family, remember me in prayer. If you've enjoyed the service, please push the like button and pass it on to all the out there that through Facebook, Google, whatever. And maybe change somebody's soul today. Because the truth has been spoken. You can take it or you can leave it. But I'll tell you this much. If you don't accept it, you'll be judged by it, and you'll go to hell for it. This is yours truly, the Evangelist, Willie Grizzle, from the House of Prayer. Love y'all. God bless.
People say I'm no good and crazy as a loon. Praise him in the morning, and I praise him in the afternoon. I'm kinda like the saints of old, I love to trust him and obey. I don't have to worry, cause I fall on my knees and pray. I ain't asking nobody for nothing, when I can get it from God's throne. Yeah, I can. You don't like the way I'm living, you just leave this Holy Ghost filled preacher alone. You see the preacher man talking on the TV, and he's trying to guide my soul. Tells me to hold to a promise, trust Jesus and don't let go. You see, Jesus walked on the water, and I know that is true. Next time you see him come a-walking, he'll be walking on the clouds for you. And I ain't asking nobody for nothing, oh, when I can get it from God's throne. Oh, yeah. If you don't like the way I'm living, you just leave. Holy Ghost filled preacher alone. Well, a poor man wants a dollar, and a rich man wants a name. A rich man for honor, and the poor man fights the pain. Well, the drunkard
wants another drink of wine, and a blind man wants to see. But Jesus died on a rugged old cross to set all four men free. And I ain't asking nobody for nothing when I can get it from God's throne. Yeah, I can. If you don't like the way I'm living, you just leave this Holy Ghost filled preacher.